Welcome back. Wanted to make a quick video on helping you learn how to back up your keys, encrypt your keys, and even adding keys to an image. With your client open, simply click on the file tab at the top left of the screen, and you can click on the backup wallet from the drop-down menu. And it asks you to choose a folder to save each key to. We don't recommend saving them in the same location, but for this example, I'm going to do just that to speed things up. I'll save it to the first backup location folder here. And note, you don't have to have it named key one. That's just the default name. It could be anything you want. So it is named Alice. And as long as the file extension is under private key here, or .private, that's all you really need to know. And we will save the second private key to second backup location. And we will call it Bob. Okay, key files have been backed up. All right, now if we want to encrypt those key files, notice those backups I just did were not encrypted. So they're not password protected. Two things here, basically. You can back up original keys that are unencrypted, and you could always load them back up and add a new encryption to them, a new passphrase to them. But if anyone gets their hands on them, they would have access as well. Whereas if they got their hands on a private key that was encrypted, they would also have to know the passphrase. So we are going to encrypt our keys here. Important, you can give each private key a different password if you wish. If you forget any of your passwords, the wallet will be useless. This is also true if you are on a joint account. If you or your partner forgets their password, neither of you will be able to spend from that account. You can use the same password for both keys, or you can choose to protect only one, or you can give each key a different password, which is even higher security. And here it's explaining this again. You can back up your original keys in a safety deposit box. That way you would have keys unencrypted, meaning they wouldn't have a password protecting them. But they're very vulnerable if someone else got their hands on them that you didn't want. If you have backed up already, make sure those files don't contain your unencrypted keys. Think carefully before proceeding. Passphrases are always superior to passwords. Hint, a line from your favorite book with a number on the end is way more superior than swordfish. So, then it takes you to this window here. It's asking us to find which key we want to open and password protect. So I will go to these folders I had previously saved to, and I will password protect Alice and enter the password for this private key. Confirm. And you've finished encrypting one key. Now we go and do it again for the second key. Same thing, open the key we want. So we go back to test folder and it's the second backup location, and we'll encrypt Bob, the bob.private key. Enter your password or passphrase, confirm, and now you've encrypted both those private keys. And then another cool, amazing feature is the key to image. This is, adds such a higher level of security compared to most existing cryptocurrency QT wallets out there. You can apply your key to an image. And for this example, we will go back to those same keys. So first you want to find the key you want to encrypt into an image. We'll go with Alice. And now it asks you to open the image you wish to use to hide the file. Both JPEG and PNG are supported. Okay, so for this example, we'll just go to the default image section here is from the Bitbay directory. Click on the folder, and we'll just find one of these. We'll go with the Hobbs PGN backup right here, and open. All right, file is now hidden inside this image. Please note, if you send these special photos over email or the internet, there's a chance the site or email provider will try to compress them. This can result in a loss of data, so always be sure to test and make sure the photo can be read after sending, and never use email or internet sites as a primary backup method for hidden keys or data. Okay, so now you've got the first key imprinted into an image. We'll go with the second one. I will go to that same folder. Oops, I'll go back to the second backup location. We'll pull the second key, and go back to this image folder. Again, you can use any image, you just got to make sure it's the right size and file type. I will use this owl. Okay, the file is now hidden inside it. All right, now if you wanted to load with those images, you could simply go to open account, normal account, and we would go back to this folder. And this was our first key, Hobbs, PG, and backup. Okay, open your second private key. I believe I was owl. So click on here, open. And there you go. It just loaded up both private keys, and there's my coins and balance. All right, I hope this helps explain those three functions for you. And thanks for watching.